Hey, and welcome to your reading today. This reading is about a message from someone in spirit. And I know we all have past loved ones, and they want to come through today with a message for you. And just take a moment and take a look at these three cards at the back here and see which one you're drawn to. And I'll have the readings and the timestamps in the comments. So if you can jump ahead if you like. But, you know, just take a moment just to tune into which card is for you today. This is a general reading. So take what resonates with you, for you, and leave the rest aside. But I want to welcome you all back to my channel, and anyone who is new, thank you very much for coming, and please feel free to like, subscribe and share. And I just want to say thank you once more. So let's get into this reading and let's see what spirit your past loved ones want to share with you today. So let's start with card number one. Card number one is the Angel of Encouragement, and it's number 11. I see that stands out to me a lot. So I know you have someone in spirit at the moment that wants to come through to let you know that they are with you, to let you know that they're cheering you on. You are faced with a little bit of, a difficult situation at the moment. There's a challenge up ahead that you don't want to, it's almost like you don't want to face it. You're pretending it's not existent. It's something you're ignoring. And it's, you know, your past loved ones are coming through to say, you know what, let's get it done. Let's keep moving forward and know that I'm here for you. It's not just one past loved one. You've actually got quite a few. There's about four or five that stand around you at the moment protecting you. It's almost like when you sleep, they are around you. And I can see that in your bedroom or even on the couch. You've been sleeping on the couch a little bit lately, because I know when I'm feeling a bit off, I go and lie on the couch. And I can see you sleeping almost in two different places at the moment, depending on how you feel, or getting up in the middle of the night and you know, getting a bit restless, having a glass of water, and then going back to lie down in a different place. That's what I'm getting with this card. So know that your loved ones are definitely here. They're saying it's not as bad as you think, and that thing is, you don't have enough information just yet. You're behaving like you've got it all. and the thing is, you don't have enough information, but they want to come through definitely to let you know that they're here. You know, the number 11 stands out the most, so I know that 11 would be significant for you, whether you see ones a lot, 111, 1111, that type of thing. When you do see that, know that they're giving you that encouragement, that they're here for you, okay? I just want to get a little bit more information and see what your message is, outside of the fact that they're telling you that it's going to be exactly what it needs to be, and it's time that you move forward and use them like your cheerleaders. So you just keep moving forward, okay? We've got the third chakra, Archangel Shamuel. Very nice. Third chakra. Now, third chakra is our solar plexus, our emotional center. Ooh, you've got the Daughter Romance. Again, 33. The numbers are standing out a lot. So you must have, oh gosh, a lot of numbers coming out for you. So notice the numbers if you aren't already, but I really feel like you are. Okay, so the first card we've got is a third chakra. The second card is the Door to Romance. And the third one is the Temple Path. So I want to talk about this decision that's coming up for you. It's time that you, like I said, feel support from your past loved ones that are here to show you that they are around you. They're around you when you sleep and you're recuperating. They're around you when you're in your daydreams, just getting on with life. But all, yeah, it feels like sometimes you go out of your body and you come back and you go, oh, what am I doing? Oh, that's right, I'm here in the kitchen cooking dinner, or I'm here driving a car. Like, I really want you to come back much quicker, and that's what your past loved ones are doing for you. They're bringing you into the human existence. Now, the emotions are switching you off. Sometimes you feel like you can't, you know, experience joy in a joyous situation, or you're not getting upset when someone's pissing you off. It's just like, meh, meh. It's this numbness. So it's time that I encourage you to go to YouTube and look for some solar plexus activations. You're getting a real big emotional activation at the moment with your past loved ones coming forward to open up stagnant energy that you've been carrying around a lot in this area. So I wouldn't be surprised if there's any upset tummies going on, or some, you know, maybe constipation holding so tightly onto the way you feel and not letting yourself express it to flow. So know that, your loved ones are here to say, look, this is all emotional. It's an emotional roller coaster for you at the moment, and really tune into that solar plexus to start releasing that tension and moving forward. Now, the next card we have is the Door to Romance. So whether or not this, you know, this is, regardless if you're in a relationship or not, the Door to Romance is flowing for you now. It's a place where you can, if you're in a relationship, it's something that will awaken again. I feel like I need to say those words again. This will awaken again if you're in a relationship. The thing is, because you've been in this state, you haven't been present in your relationships. And the thing is, when you're not present in relationships, you can't feel. You can't feel that joy. You can't feel that connection. So your past loved ones are coming in today to say, it's time that you start opening that cage around your heart and letting yourself feel the love, letting yourself experience the emotions that you have in the pit of your stomach to express what's going on and start that flow. If you aren't in a relationship, you're going to do this stuff, which is going to change your frequency and your energy. So people are going to be more drawn to you. You're going to be noticed by people that actually haven't, you know, maybe made you feel like they've looked through you. You're actually going to be present now and be able to attract. There's definite romance coming, regardless if you're in a relationship or not. The only thing that can prevent this is if you're not doing this step first, letting your past loved ones come in and help heal you while you sleep, while you daydream. Ask for them to come close, because that's what they're doing right now. This is a very exciting time, and it's probably really scary for some of you that's not ready for romance. It doesn't have to be relationships. It can just be beautiful exchanges of energy. You know, a nice cuppa, a nice ear to lend. It doesn't have to be something huge. So don't start replaying old stories about how this is going to play out. Let yourself just drift into a nice flow of energy and be open to this, okay? Because when you do this, you're going to be able to get back on purpose. You're going to be on the temple path. If you have a look at this card, already it makes me want to walk up these stairs and just stand in this beautiful space and just absorb the energy. And this is what you're creating right now. You're creating your space. I wouldn't be surprised if you actually made yourself a nice temple, or you've made a space in the house where you just go and sit. There may be a piece of grass out the backyard that calls you. You won't want to sit there for 10 or 15 minutes a day or something, just to let yourself keep the flow of energy, because up until now it's been challenging for you. There's something that's coming up for you that you want to avoid. Know that you've got your past loved ones here giving you that encouragement. Notice the numbers. When you see the 111s, the 333s, that type of thing, know that your beautiful past loved ones are with you. I know I get the name Marie here as well. This may not resonate for all of you, but I know the name Marie here is significant. So if that's for you, then I'm really pleased. If not, just let that one go. But that is your reading for card number one. Know that we have our past loved ones with us, and it's time that you let them in, because you don't have to do this next step alone. And up until now, it's like you've been thinking that that's the only option, and it's certainly not. Okay, so that is card number one. All right. So let's see what card number two brings us. Card number two. Ooh, Angel of Wisdom. What a beautiful card this is. You know, I don't even look at these cards before I do these readings. I meditate on them and I pull out the right ones. But just having a look at this is absolutely phenomenal. Now, the thing with this one is it's the flowers in the background that I'm being drawn to the most. And we've got the angel there. She looks a little bit, you know, she looks a little bit complacent. And I know it's the Angel of Wisdom, but I feel that the message here is that you're looking in books or Googling information, you know, for your wisdom. Now, this is your past loved ones coming forward to let you know it's time to look into your inner wisdom, into your inner knowing, because you actually already know what you need to know. But you're doubting yourself and you're going into the books and you're reading and you're asking for people's opinions and all the rest of it. And as you can see, this woman here is focused and the light's shining from the book. So it's like, that's gospel. And it doesn't need to be, because she's missing out on all these flowers behind her and the wisdom of nature. And if you have a look at the beautiful angel there, she looks a little bit complacent, like, I have a job here, but someone's not listening. That's what I got out of this card. So the Angel of Wisdom is your loved ones are coming close to let you know, put the books down for just a minute. And I don't tend to say that to people. I say, keep learning. But this is not the time for learning. This is the time, as in from outside sources, this is a time for going into the inner wisdom and learning from what you've already been through, what you already know. Okay? So let's grab this deck and see what more needs to be said with the angel. Oh, that definitely was an Angel of Wisdom. It's really hard for you to let yourself be right, by the way. Like, you'll say something and you'll know it's right, but then someone will come in and swoop in and just say, well, no, it might be this way or this way. Yeah, actually. And then you start doubting yourself. And in that is the reason why your past loved ones have come in today to say, that's it, stop taking the books for gospel. Stop listening to the media and saying, well, that's it. You know, it has to be right. The thing is, these things have been proven wrong over and over again, but it doesn't matter what anyone says or what the TV says or what the books say. You know, and you're not backing yourself. Now, the first card we have is acceptance. Oh, this is bloody beautiful. It's time that your past loved ones want to say, let yourself be your magical self. You're really still beating yourself up, like things that are happening are your fault when they're completely out of your control and these type of things. And if you just accept that you've been through these experiences, it's what you've been through. It's not, you know, it's not who you are. And really harness them and tap into them for that magic feeling that you can get when you realize that you're actually pretty good. You're actually pretty good, yet there's still this doubt going on because you're second-guessing yourself and doing research elsewhere when you know, you've got this gut feeling and you just know what's good for you, yet you're doubting yourself. So when you start accepting yourself, you'll be able to flow more. And I know I said flow a lot in the first reading, but flow is the word of the day because, as you can see, this is the mermaid, messages from the mermaid deck that I was drawn to for card number two. And you can see just the way she flows. She's in the water. The fish are just swimming around her. She's quite content. And, you know, there's not much else bothering her because she's fully just gone, you know what, I surrender, it is what it is, and accept whatever's going on here. The next card we get is relaxation. So in that acceptance, you'll be able to then take the time to just take a breath and go, you know what, there's no more reading, there's no more listening, I don't need to do that for now, because I really want you to take at least a week or two now to reset. That's what the message is that I'm receiving here from your past loved ones. It's giving you permission to just stop for a minute and take a week or two. So whether or not you're, you know, in a place where you feel restricted, whether you're in a place where you feel that you can't do what you want to be doing, it's because you're meant to be just sitting in it, relaxing, switching off, putting the literature down, putting the Google down, putting the TV off, as in anything that's going to trigger you. Be having soft music, meditations, writing. Just tune into who you are, because you already know what to do here, yet you're still thinking that it's not right. And that's what's keeping you stuck. You take yourself 2 weeks. 2 weeks from whenever you listen to this video. This is timeless, this reading. So you take off 2 weeks and just, you know, don't try and do too much at once. Don't try to do too much at once. And as you can see, the most beautiful card comes next, because in that, it's almost like a detox, and it doesn't have to be a physical cleanse, but it's certainly a detox. So it's just the writing or the just switching off. It's like a detox. So any level of detox is certainly what I'd be saying is right for you right now. And that's what I'm seeing here with the past loved ones message, because in that, in 2 weeks' time, you'll be feeling so much freer. You'll be breaking free from the chains of all this heaviness of relying on outsources when you know yourself. How do you feel about it? Is it something that'll work for you? Go for it. If you don't feel right, then I'll tell you right now, you are right. Don't do it. Sit with it. But give yourself 2 weeks. 2 weeks to sit with this, to switch off. Just literally unplug. Give yourself 2 weeks. That is your message from your past loved ones now. You've got the inner wisdom. Stop doubting yourself and stop looking outside. And that is your reading for card number 2. All right. Now, a beautiful message from our past loved ones, number 3. Oh, yes. The Angel of Power. Time to make a move. Time to make a move, sisters and brothers. You cannot sit still for another second. This card is almost the exact opposite to the one where I've just said sitting back for 2 weeks. It's now or never. It's absolutely now or never. You know what to do. It's action time. You have got the most magical team, not only past loved ones, I'm getting like spirit guides, like spirit that you don't even know yet, like you actually haven't connected with them. But you know what? It doesn't matter, because the time is, what is it? The time is of essence, or whatever that saying is. That is all about card number 3 at the moment from your past loved ones. You know you're ready. You've been holding on to this for a while, whatever your next move is. And if you don't know what your next move is, just move. Just move, okay? The Empress of the Night. Okay. All right, next one. The Sacred Orchid. And I just want to shuffle for one more card. And beautiful. Oh, this is very cool. This is very cool, really. So the first one we got is the Empress of the Night, a finale. After the storm, I emerge a shiny new star. That is you right now. You are ready to rock. Okay, like over here, it's, you know, time to retreat, time to ponder, all the rest of it. You've done enough of that. You have literally just gone, all right, no more wallowing, no more. And I'm not saying that you're all wallowing. I apologize for that word. When I said that, I was like, wrong. No more wallowing is not the word. The word is no more procrastinating, okay? Because it's time for you now to shine. The world needs to see you. The world needs to see you, and you are ready. Because after the storm, I emerge a shining new star. That is you. You are the star that is being reborn. You have put everything into place. There is nothing more for you to do now but action, 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 action. The next card is the Sacred Orchid. Co-create. My abundance mindset attracts endless beings. You may not know after you do this action what's next after that, but that's okay, because you don't need to know. Look, if you've got a plan, that's great. But I want to sort of liken this to when I had my children. I didn't have a birth plan. My plan was to have a healthy baby, and whatever happened, happened. So keep your focus on the outcome, and whatever needs to happen for that to fall into place will happen. If you stay rigid on what is meant to happen step by step, you will miss the flow of things. You will miss the opportunity for this to happen for you rather than happening to you. Or, you know, you don't want to hold the reins too tight with this one. Be a bit more accepting and a bit more willing to get it wrong. Because when and if you get it wrong, you won't stay there for too long. You'll just go, okay, cross, that doesn't work, and you'll keep going. You won't actually put your tools down and just, you know, say this is all too hard, like I'm sure you have once or twice before, because we're human. This is all about action. This is all about moving forward. And with your idea or your next move, if you've already done it, keep going. If you haven't, it's time now, okay? You can call in people, call in like-minded people. You don't have to look for them. You need to sit back and expect them to turn up. They will turn up in all different ways, unexpected synchronicities, all that type of thing. Be open to building this every minute of the day. You're going to be feeling, knowing, getting downloads, dropped in, awakenings, overhearing conversations, you know, flicking the channel on the radio or the TV going, oh, hang on a minute, oh, I just needed to hear that one thing. And it just keeps the momentum flowing. But this is something that you don't need to do alone. You can, but ask for the right people to pop in and they can help you along the way, okay? So this is your baby, but it's getting the right people at the right time. It might be just for one conversation or one cup of coffee, or it might be for a few months. You'll know who and when, because you'll just know. You'll just feel it and you'll just go, oh my gosh, you've turned up. I can't ignore this. Divine timing. And no, because your past loved ones are in here now going, okay, enough grieving over losing us, enough looking at the past, enough of that sort of stuff. It's now time to go, it is what it is. I'm strong. I've got this boost of power from my past loved ones. It's time for me to be the superhero and move forward. A little bit dramatic? I don't think so. I think it's fitting. It's perfect. Because the last card you get here is the Oracle. And this, oh, I am the Oracle. My intuitive insights flow freely. And it's time for you to just really, really embrace all possibilities. It's scary because you might actually succeed. And the thing is, this reading here is all about success. It's all about success. You wait another minute, you won't be able to get with the flow. It's all about flow. All three of these cards are all about flow. There's no more research that needs to be done. There's no more sitting down and nutting out numbers. There's nothing. Whatever happens next is exactly what your past loved ones are saying. Time. Let's do this. Let's put that superhero cape on and just move forward, because it's beautiful energy. You're completely supported by the universe, by your past loved ones, by the people that will come in, the conversations you'll hear. Everything's aligned for you. The stars are aligned. It's now time to work through this. And the only thing that can slow you down is you, because it's only going to be an excuse that you make up along the way. And like I said, if you get it wrong, it's not wrong. It's just not the right way. And you just veer the other way. Okay, so that is card number 3 from your past loved ones, the Angel of Power. Please take whatever resonates for you with these readings, because as you know, they are general. But I know that the messages that have come through are absolutely divinely guided from our past loved ones. I hope you really enjoyed that, and thank you very much for tuning in. Please do tune in next time, and like, subscribe, and do all those Facebook algorithm things. And please take care, stay well, and look after others, but definitely look after you. Peace out. Bye.